Hello guys, my name is Victoria Pavlov. I'm the Photoshop artist, and today we will talk about tools. We will talk about first set of tools in a toolbar. Let's start. As you can see, I have created my document with three layers. First layer is background layer, which is locked, and another layer is an unlocked layer. I renamed this layer to number one, and this layer has a black color. Next layer is number two layer. Also, this layer is unlocked, and I have and I will use red color for this layer. So guys, also I have selected my move tool. In the options bar, I can specify a few options for my move tool. If I will click in select after select box, Photoshop will select top layer for me. Next to it, I have two options. I can specify from drop-down menu group or layers. Next to it, I have show transform controls. If I will specify, select this option, I will see that Photoshop displays the bounding box around my layer. So I can modify my layer, I can make it smaller or bigger, I can rotate it, I can move it without selecting my free transform tool. If I will be satisfied with my modification, I will click and accept this layer, or I can cancel my modifications. If you would like to move few layers in same time, you can do this as well. So I will make my top layer, red layer, smaller, just like that, and I will move it using my move tool. I will accept it. Now I will select my layer number one, black layer, and I will modify this layer just like that. And I will click OK to accept my changes. So I would like to move my two layers in same time. I will select my two layers, my black layer and a red layer, and I will be able to move my layers, to resize them, to rotate them in same time. Also, I can click OK to accept my modifications. Also, guys, in the options bar, we have option to align our layers. We can align our layers in many, many ways. So everything depends on your project or your on your composition and everything like that. So guys, before we will jump to our next tool, artboard tool, I would like to bring your attention that you will be not able to preview the bounding box around your layer if you will try to apply modification to your background layer, which is locked. So guys, let me hide my top layers, red and black, and I will highlight my background layer, and which is locked. And as you can see, I cannot preview the bounding box around my layer. When I will unlock my layer, to unlock your layer, simply click on icon on a lock icon, and you will be able to unlock your layer. After I unlocked my layer, I'm able to see the bounding box around my layer, and I can use these handlers to move, rotate, or resize my layer. So guys, you will be able to preview and use the bounding box around your layer or selection only if you are working with unlocked layers. Now time to jump to our second tool, to artboard tool. To create a new artboard, you need to go to File, New, and here, after you will specify all parameters for your new document, you need to click on artboard box. After you will select artboard box, you need to click on Create, and voila, Photoshop created new artboard for you. And Photoshop renamed this new artboard to artboard number one. Definitely you can rename your artboard. Double click on artboard's name and you will be able to rename your artboard. Now I will switch to my artboard tool, And you can see after I switch to my artboard tool, I have all plus sign icons around my artboard number one. If I will click on any of them, I will create a new artboard. Of course, I will rename it. I will rename it to artboard 2 and number 3. Just voila. So I have selected my artboard 3. And if I would like to change size for my already created artboard, I can do it without any problem. I can do it in two ways. First way, I can specify size from drop-down menu in properties panel, just I'm doing right now. I will specify my size to iPad mini, and voila, Photoshop resized my artboard for me. Now I will click and select my artboard number 2, and in the options bar from a size drop down menu, I will click and select iPad mini as well, and voila, Photoshop renamed resized my artboard for me. If I would like to change orientation for my artboard, I can do it as well. Now I have horizontal orientation. If I will click, I will change it to vertical, and I will be, if I will click on horizontal, I will be back to horizontal orientation. This is so cool. If you would like to delete your artboard, you can do it as well. Simply the right click on your artboard layer, and you will be able to delete your artboard. It's a very easy and a very fast way of deleting your artboard. If you would like to export your artboard, you need to go to File, Export, and here you can export your file to PDF. So you will be able to specify destination for your artboard, and you need to specify all parameters. After you will be satisfied with everything, click Run, and your artboard will be saved as PDF file. If you would like to save export your artboard to some specific file, you need to click Artboards to File, and here you need to specify destination for your artboard. Example, if you would like to add this artboard to specific project, you will be able to locate this project, specify a few parameters for your artboard, and click Run, and voila, you will be ready to go. I will click Cancel now. So guys, this is very easy. This is very fun. I love working with artboard, not only with my web project, but with my photography, because example, if I will have two different project with same image, example, if my client wants to see hello, how are you image with red and a white text on it, I will use my artboards to create same image with two different texts, and I will send it to my client, and my client will be back to me with his or her opinion. So guys, this is our first set of tools. Tomorrow we will talk about another set of tools in a toolbar. Thank you guys. I hope you liked it. And if you have any questions, as usual, please ask. I will be more than happy to answer to any of your questions. And I will see you later. Bye guys.